to talk today a little bit about my experience as an educator in Colorado. In 2005, I took a job teaching a disadvantaged youth in one of the poorest neighborhoods in Denver. I was filled with the hope and the promise that I'd be the one to make a difference in these kids' lives, and I'd be the one to help them achieve at rates they've never seen before and close the achievement gap. I never struggled more professionally than I did in that year, as every day my kids came in unmotivated, and I worked out of frustration, pushing them daily through their assignments. I still remember one day when I put up on my board a writing prompt. I asked my kids to respond to the question, or to the statement, describe a regret that you've had in your life. After begging my kids for 5 minutes to keep their pencils on their paper, I called upon them to give their answer, and one of my most reluctant and defiant students shot his hand up in the air with unusual enthusiasm, and I called upon him, and his answer was, having such a crappy English teacher. I know. So I was stunned. I wasn't stunned so much about his opinion of me. I figured he didn't think much of my teaching skills as I struggled on a daily basis to keep the class focused. But I was more stunned that he didn't see the obvious role that he played in obstructing the learning in that classroom. Fast forward 2 more years, and I'd moved on, and I became the educator of the year at the largest correctional educational facility in Colorado. 3 more years, and I became the principal, and today I still proudly run Ridgeview Academy in Watkins, Colorado, which houses some of the most at-risk kids in the state, committed by the Division of Youth Corrections in the Department of Human Services. Despite our difficult population, we achieve at rates that most schools don't see. For the past 2 years, we've been the highest performing Denver public charter school in all of DPS. And we've also earned a 4th ranking out of 60 alternative high schools in the state on ColoradoSchoolGrades.com for outstanding longitudinal academic performance. We've also won the Colorado Division of Education's Center for Excellence Award the last 2 years for having outstanding academic results on our assessments. How do we achieve these results? But even more importantly, why were my experiences so different at these two facilities? I think now that the answer is one of institutional perspective, and that's a perspective of positive youth development. In a nutshell, positive youth development asks adults to look at students as having their glasses half full instead of half empty. Unlike the language that predominated the behavioral sciences in the 60s and 70s that encouraged us to look at adolescents as broken or at risk to be broken, positive youth development takes a more positive approach. It encourages us to create pro-social relationships with kids, to identify their passions and interests, and help them grow them in a wide array of activities and vocations and academics, so that we can build them up so that they can be better equipped to be positive members of society. What does positive youth development in corrections look like? Well, first of all, I can tell you what it doesn't look like, and it doesn't look like a prison. Instead of housing these kids in drab facilities, surrounded by 25-foot fences and razor wire, clad in prison uniforms, with restraining devices and bars and poorly funded educational programs, PYD asks us to do the opposite. It asks us to give these kids the advantages and privileges that our kids from the advantaged neighborhoods get, and more. It asks us to create a rigorous academic program that can prepare these kids for college and post-secondary opportunities. It asks us to create real-world vocational opportunities and skills that can get these kids employed. And it also asks us to involve them in a wide range of activities and fun activities like sports and robotics that get these kids engaged again in society. Why don't we have more PYD programs and corrections? I think the answer is simple, and the answer is one word: punishment. From the beginning of time, it's been mankind's knee-jerk reaction to make those that have wronged society suffer. The problem with this approach is it doesn't work, and it's never worked. Even though that's been the predominant mindset in this country for all of corrections, for over 200 years, our prison rates have continued to soar. And it's at a great strain to all of our communities. PYD offers another approach, an approach for correctional youth that works. The first part of PYD, you'll find in the 5 C's, is confidence. You need these kids to develop confidence in their skills and in their assets so that they can utilize them successfully in the community. Too many of my kids have been denigrated, put down, told that they'll be amount to nothing in their lives, and lecturing them and further punishing them and making them suffer does not work. That's why at my facility we use a 5-to-1 positive to negative feedback ratio. We need to get these kids on a positive roll. We need to get these kids to feel good about the skills that they already own and develop them further. The second C is just as important, and that's character. Most of my kids have had very poor role models in their lives, and they do not know how to identify the kind of character traits that are necessary to be a successful person. So we have to explicitly teach them to identify those character traits and practice them in a real-world situation. And there's always connections as well. My students have broken off from society for the most part, and we need to repair that connection. And that's a two-way street to repair that connection. We need to get the kids out into the community doing good things so that they feel good about giving back to society. And we need society to see these correctional youth doing good things so they can change their view of what their potential is. And we also need to focus on caring and compassion. Most of my students have grown up in negative environments and have been put down, as I said before. This is the most fun part of positive youth development. Instead of making them suffer in a regular correctional educational setting, we can create positive pro-social adult relationships with these kids and positive peer-to-peer relationships with these kids so they can grow and develop into positive members in society. I know PYD works, and I know it works because I've lived it. I watch kids come into my facility every day and defiant, reckless, unmotivated, and leave poised professionals ready to work and contribute to society. But if you don't want to take my word for it, I want to show you some of the outcomes that we've achieved in my program. In the first 10 years of operation, this is what we reported on our 10-year report, we've achieved over 110,000 hours of meaningful public service, more than 300 hours of cognitive-based treatment per youth per year. We've created the safest program of its kind in Colorado and among the top 10% safest in the nation. We have issued 400 high school diplomas, more than $150,000 of college scholarships earned, 90% program completion rate, 12,000 GEDs, over 2,300 program completers, and over $200,000 of restitution paid while the kids are in our program. 88% of our exiting students leave enrolled or employed, or both. 4 division sports championships, 2 national robotics awards, and more than 600 hours of physical exercise per kid per year. And that's just some of the outcomes that we've had, and we've even continued it on into this decade as well. Thank you. I think as a society, we need to promote more programs for wayward youth that use positive youth development as a framework. When you achieve outcomes like that, it's its own reward. And it's a motivating factor for the adults that work with these kids to go even further the next day. I know because I come into work every day smiling and ready to go with my students. It works, and we need to make sure we have the resources for these kids. These kids are a precious resource that's wasted. For every kid that ends up in jail and wastes their life, there's $10 more spent down the road than we spend now. And I know it works. And let's face it, in this world, we don't need any more crappy English teachers. Thank you, folks.